screen doesn't go. Just keep going.
All right, guys.
So, last one,
yeah, this is myself, Black Treasure.
Yeah.
Alongside. Brother Brooklyn and the home tree step. You already know what it is.
Yeah, yeah.
You need to ask Christian.
Yeah.
Graveyards and all that.
Yeah.
We're looking at like where they put us, like, in this grass, brother. UK, London. Yo, South London, right?
South
Thames River, London.
Yeah.
Y'all know the Aylesbury Estate?
Aylesbury.
Elephant and Castle?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Guess what that's built on? A graveyard. You heard of Chowfield Estate?
Say that again.
It was built on a graveyard. The Aylesbury Estate, the biggest housing project in the whole of Europe, right? Y'all know about the Chalk Hill Estate that used to be in Wembley, by the 306 freeway, Harsden, Wembley, Northwest Town, built on a graveyard. Y'all know about Broadwater Farm, built on a graveyard. Y'all know about Edmonton Ring, built on a graveyard.
Yes, sir.
Y'all know about the estate.
Yo, so what? Yo.
Built on a graveyard. Why did they keep putting us there? There.
Let me ask now, because.
Go ahead.
Asked again.
Hello.
The reasoning amongst I and ourselves, Dean.
Inside the library.
We're asking. I say, ask a simple question.
The
is he
library,
the one?
The library,
this
the
one. Archives, his Imperial archives. Majesty.
Actually, sir, this. You write an exact. You write an exact. Because everybody else, though,
you know who you look like. Right. And I know people tell you all the time.
Who?
Julian Marley.
Yo, every.
Yeah, Julian.
Look, this is what you got, you know, do I need you in a fight, right? One second, I got this.
Yeah.
Every rascal who sees this guy as their guidance,
yeah,
is correct. Every 5% who sees Pudding or Father of Law or Clarence Fertinex is correct.
Yeah.
Every Christian who sees a black Jesus as their father figure is correct. Huh? Every Nuapu, Pian, who sees Malachi as New York as their guidance is correct. Every Morrisan Temple who sees Noble Jolly as their guy is correct.
Yeah.
Every single nation Islam who sees Abu Bakr Muhammad or Louis Farrakhan as their guy is correct.
Correct. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But
yeah,
as I said earlier on,
yeah,
it's all leading to the same path or Tatar.
Now,
as you say,
that's
in the middle natural or Muap. So we're all trying to get to that, but we're
going
to question
what?
Who's trying to separate us? Who's trying to separate us is the Tamahawk.
Mm-hmm.
Split sleeper, as in Congo deserves.
Mm-hmm.
Especially for the fools. This is what we forget. If you keep consuming the production diet, you're going to think they're Europeans. You're going to get these diseases. Diabetes.
True.
My friend, it's cancer. That wasn't even heard of in the motherland. AIDS, all these gay diseases. That wasn't even heard of in the motherland. So there's a correlation, right? Look at these school children coming out of school right now.
Yeah.
They're walking down the block, the avenue, eating pigeon and chips.
Yeah.
I say pigeon and chips, you ain't seen no chicken delivery in the
hood. Okay.
And the chips is potato, white skin potato. Look at rats, mice, and vermin.
Yeah.
You know what kills them? What the poison is called?
What?
The poison is called arsenic. Where does the arsenic come from?
What arsenic is a chemical?
Well, arsenic comes from the skin of the white potato.
Okay, okay.
So why are you eating chips?
Okay.
And why are you even walking around here if you're eating hot food anyway? It doesn't make no sense. I don't eat anything with face and ass and eat things at room temperature. Mother Nature's blessing me with natural food. Let the fruits be for food and the green leaf be for medicine. You got me? So I don't eat anything with face and
ass. You have to tell him. Yeah. Ask him.
Come on in, it's all great.
Is his Imperial Majesty, the Creator? And then man is telling me that.
I said to her, yes. To any master family, so I see, is that guidance? That's good. Any more science symbol, brother?
Can I put
you on any guidance?
Yo.
Everybody's got different guidance, see? But we're all to one man. One should, one love.
Surprised you're not stepping on no one's toes.
Yeah.
That's it.
But look at the person who's trying to divide us all, though. Why ain't no one like pointing fingers at the divider, the Tamil?
So who the divider?
It's not who you worship, it's your acts.
No.
The divider.
It's about how you live.
Yeah, yeah,
how
yeah.
How you treat others.
I'm glad
you
said
that. It's about saying child all day, but if you're aggressive, or you don't have the eloquence to talk to people nicely, or learn from others, or try and meet people halfway.
Exactly. It's your intention.
Lost the purpose.
It's your intention.
Intention.
It's how you apply
it's
it.
It's true, it's true.
How do you apply the knowledge to make sense in real life, in real time?
It's true.
And how do you realize the real life? You be alive. Your first eye, your third eye, your first eye, your canyon going on. You follow
it's
up.
It's true.
Turn off the TV, turn off the radio, man. None of the self. You are the living God inside you. I don't mean that as spookism. You are the Nafano, you are the Most High.
On top of it.
You are the universe. Everything you see in the galaxy, no questions, omniverse. It's inside you, it's in the world, man. You're probably the crystallization. What's up with that? You can go under your own arm, baby.
Yeah.
Don't let anybody tell you different. Go ahead, question.
So I asked you again. Where are you going? Where are you going? Let's say
I'm
that one
where
again.
I'm going.
So
because let me break it down real simple, right?
Yeah.
I acknowledge all my descendants, okay?
Yeah.
I acknowledge those who came before me and paved the way.
Yeah.
So I acknowledge your salutations to all my descendants. However, as a light being right now, 2016,
yeah.
I'm not descending. I'm trying to ascend. So I'm acknowledging more time my ascendants. Alright? Look at Dr. Frances Kurtz Wilson. She ascended recently. She didn't die because energy can't dissipate. She's been to the next round.
Yeah.
Dr. Delbert Blair, who dealt with metaphysics, he didn't die, he just transitioned to the next round. My mother, she left this plane 3 years ago. She didn't die as a physical death, as you call it, but she just transcended. So I'm trying to be like my ascendants. Why do people call these great people's names before us?
Enough, in my job, you don't have to die to go to heaven.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And you know, when it comes to Christ being crucified, that's not Jah's best plan. You know, when he's
so
why do you call him Jah? Why do you guys call
him? There's many names for Jah. There's many names.
Okay. You know what I mean? But which is the name he come by? That's what I want to know.
Listen,
what name he come
so
what?
If you deal with ancient Egyptian, they would say Nekka.
Then probably Ra was the first.
But, all right, what name? What is this? What is this?
Amun Ra.
What is this?
Amun Ra, that pharaoh called Amun Ra was where the name Amen arrived from.
What is his coronation name
even
in 1930, ladies and
gentlemen? You're giving it a gender.
Yeah, you can't gender.
Yo, shall I put you in?
There was Ra, and there was Amen. That was the upper and the lower part of Egypt. Right. You understand me?
Yeah.
Because the lower part of Egypt, right, which is the top of part of Africa. Yes. You understand me?
Yeah.
It was more invaded, right, and they took over the people in the higher part of Egypt, which is the part that is deeper into Africa, right, because the Nile flows up. You understand me?
Yeah.
So they held on to Amen. They didn't let go. When the Egyptians took back over, they recognized that the people left that was up on the upper part of Egypt never gave in. They never gave in. They held on to Amen. So now when the country came back together, upper and lower Egypt became and then known as Amen Ra. Which is as today you have the Christians saying Amen, which is Amen. And the Muslims saying Amen. Yeah, it's the same thing. You understand me? So all of it, no matter where it goes, it comes right back around. But even the Egyptians, Egyptian kings, they would have a concubine. You understand me?
Yeah.
And that concubine would be from Ethiopia. Because they always said that the Christ would come from Ethiopia.
Yeah.
You understand me? So this is things that even our ancient ancestors had already known and have developed.
At the end of the day, it's still down to
but when the Greek or Romans came home.
Down to what?
And how you live.
With that yeah, everything is down to how you live.
Yeah, well, what I wanted to say is that you see the 42 laws of Mat?
Yeah.
That's the best. Mat. That's the best guidance you can have. Apart, and then you can.
So
you can support
that's that. Everything
but,
else comes out of.
Yeah, but you can also support that with the teachings of His Imperial Majesty.
Before I remember,
but to a white man. But to a white man, yeah, I can't force that kind of the teachings of His Majesty because His Majesty was predominantly for the rebirth of Africa. Yeah.
No, His Majesty was predominantly for the unification and the oneness of mankind. Hold on. That's what we see him as because we was going on like that. Mm. But when you talk to Kennedy and you talk to all the different leaders,
it's true.
In China, no,
it's true. Mao Zedong, all of them. It's true.
Okay, who told Kennedy that this Miss Madison?
It's true. And after 2 weeks.
Hold on, listen, this is the last time I'll be seeing you.
Two weeks.
Octagon, up and down with His Majesty, all around the place.
Yeah, it's true.
His Majesty left Kennedy.
Shut.
Drove around.
Shut.
True.
Marcus, so the head leaders, they know her.
They know the head leaders, they know
how can it be? You don't like all the diaspora. Not the divide, trying to unify all of us as a coalition, yo.
So what I want to know is, do you doubt Haile Selassie divinity? That's what I want to know.
Listen, there are many gods,
I don't doubt, because
the
minute I doubt anyone's divinity, it means I doubt my own divinity. And I believe my own brilliance, so I don't doubt
what anybody. Haile Selassie, without any apologies, the Christ who come back yourself. In the power of the Trinity, His name holds power, the first power of the
Tell them what Haile Selassie, yeah, it's true.
Listen,
listen, listen. Where does he come into
Empress
it?
Manon.
What do you mean, where is she coming into it? That's his wife.
Yeah.
His wife.
As a physical, living in the physical, showing the union between man and woman.
A woman, yes.
It's supposed to be.
Yeah. Because no man and man.
It says, first it said that God created man in his own image, in his own likeness. He created them both.
Yeah.
Male and female.
Yeah, yeah.
Later on down. Next chapter. Hold on, next chapter. Because you were talking, I said, man, I heard everything.
It's good to listen, it's good to listen. Yes, yes, easy.
Next chapter, as we forward on, says that what? Man got lonely, God took the rib, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, yeah,
So when you go into all of those reasons, man, that's why you see you have all of this thing with, you know, man is like hermaphrodites and all of them things, things and whatever. You got the man and the woman sex thing and that. They saying that's how it was originally. That's why some people is saying now to up until today, well, you know, it's original because man and woman was as one and blah, blah, blah. Now, that's why these people are saying, hold on, not saying and using
the school lesson, yes.
You understand me? But there was, God made man and woman in his likeness, in his own
separation. That bit there, like the hermaphrodite and all that, that's part of our timeline that got jacked, and it got jacked by the Hindu influence, because they're the only ones who go on with that.
Medically, these things do go on. So you got to understand, from long time ago, the mucking about with the genes, that's why the book is called Genesis. Because it's your genes, the genes of ISIS.
Which really should be called in Aramaic Hebrew. So how are people? How are people that are born with both genitals? Yeah. How are they determined?
All right. Look. This is how it's determined. They check them from inside. You understand me? Do they have ovaries? If they don't have, if they have ovaries inside, what they do is, they operate on them, they cut off the male thing so the woman thing can grow. Because they got ovaries and everything in the passageway inside already. So if they don't have it, then they close up the next part, sew up everything and make the penis work. You understand me?
I'm talking medically now. Are you denying that there's people born like that?
But I just told you what they do to the people who's born like that. So how are you going to answer me a question like that?
No, I'm saying, so you're trying to say that there's no human beings naturally born that have both genitals.
Right? I didn't say that. You're not listening, Virgin.
So you're basically saying
No. That's what I said. And I showed you what they do to determine
saying what they've done to them. I'm saying how they were born naturally.
Listen, that's what I said.
You understand?
You're not listening, Virgin. Take time.
Are you simply saying, like, born with both genders?
That's what he said.
That's what I just said.
No, but he's saying that they operate on them.
No, I didn't say that, Virgin. You're not listening. I'm going to say it again. How many times am I going to say you're not listening?
Yeah. They will go one way or the other.
Yes, because is it a boy or is it a girl? That's right. What they're gonna say. Wait.
Alright.
You're both saying the same thing.
No, he's asking a question that I've answered. I'm trying to show him what I'm saying. But he's keep on going. We don't work like that. Otherwise I'll walk off, Benjamin, because we're not going away. You understand me? You listen to me.
It's Sizzla.
Sizzla. I listen to know what the question is. I listen to your question.
Yeah.
Now, I'm saying, again, I said it before. Yeah. Virgin, people are born like that. That's what I said first. And I said, the question was, how do they determine? And then I gave an explanation.
Oh, okay.
You understand me?
I know that.
So then genetic manipulation comes
in. Gentlemen!
Yes, listen.
Gentlemen.
Yes.
They close down the shop in a minute, so you can take the discussion on the other side of the barrier, I'm afraid.
Is that right? No discussion.
The library closed.
Listen, this is something I used to teach.
That's okay. It's the time. Time is the enemy of all,
this is something that happens originally. It's born like that.
Hang on.
Red button, you can start again.